Hello friends, welcome to Teach Goals. Today I have a very interesting question, it's also an interview question too. And it goes like this: can you talk about managing API in your apps? Or somebody can ask why do we need API gateway? Come on, let's discuss more about this. So the slide you see on the screen is from the previous video, which is a Twitter system design. And let's see where the API gateway sits over here, right? So this is our API gateway. So the API gateway is a single entry point where all the customer calls goes and hits, and API gateway decides to call which services and it gives the right response to the customers, right? So in this, I want to correlate the airport security check with the API gateway. So if you correlate airport security check with the API gateway, it does the same operation, right? If you look at the security check at airport, what it does is it validates and authenticates the customer before going into the airport, right? So that means it does a security check. The next thing it does is it limits the entry of the passengers into the airport, right? So let's say if a lot of crowd is there, we can limit the number of passengers getting into the airport, and we can divert into some other security check or security queue, right? And if you want to count the number of customers getting into the airport, we can use this as an entry point to figure out how many customers are getting into the airport, right? Or how many passengers are getting into the airport. So API gateway also does the same thing. It counts how many requests are coming into the backend services. The security checkpoint also does the load balancing the entry. For example, if you have an n number of passengers getting into the airport, what it can do is they can divert the passengers to different security queue. In that way, the load gets balanced at one security checkpoint, right? So the same thing is done by the API gateway, right? So let's talk about why do we need the API gateway. So the first point I have is internal APIs / external APIs, right? So in your company, you might be having an internal customers, and we also have an external customers. Let's say if you want to restrict certain APIs only to the internal customers, or if you want certain APIs to be exposed to the external customers, we can have the configuration in the API gateway in such a way the APIs are restricted only to the external customer versus the internal customers, right? So let me give an example. For example, if you have a customer service system or the internal customer data within your company, and you want to expose only those information only to the internal customers, right, or internal applications, then you can go and set up a configuration in such a way these APIs can be used only for the internal customers, right? The second thing I have is API analytics. API analytics is a very important thing when you consider any kind of a software application or the web services, right? So there are multiple reasons you want to know about the analytics data. Let me give an example, right? So for example, if I want to know how is the API traffic coming into the system, right? Second thing is which API is used frequently. And there may be a question who is the most frequently used developer, right? And similarly, we can also figure out which API is slower, which API is faster, right? Also, all this information are logged into the system, and the analytical system helps us to get all those information, right? So other thing is, other example I can give is, geographically from which location the APIs are targeted, or from which location most number of APIs are used, right? So those are the analytical information which we can use from the API gateway, right? The third point I have is the API security, right? So all the APIs has to be secured without any doubt, right? So we can apply the security in multiple ways. We have to authenticate, we have to authorize the API, and we have to do the rate limiting. And there are cases where we have to give the role-based control. We can set up a lot of policy within the API gateway to achieve all those things, right? So let's talk about what is authentication. So we might be having an API in our services, and we want to authenticate the users before even trying to get access to the API. So we can apply the authentication policies, right? So what is authorization? Similar to authentication, there may be cases where we have to restrict only certain number of users to use the APIs. There we can set up a authorization policies. What is rate limiting? So rate limiting is, within a few seconds, your API may be targeted, there is a DDoS attack, right? So in that case, we don't want to expose our API, and we don't want to breach the security. So we can apply the rate limiting policy at the API gateway to make sure that we are limiting the number of requests to the any of the API. So similarly, we have a role-based control. So there is an API where only certain number of users are allowed to read or write, correct? So in this way, we can apply the role-based policy to achieve all our security principles, right? So that is what I call the API gateway is a single point of entry to apply all your security, right? So the next one I have is a load balancing. So I have another video about the load balancing within this channel. So I would like you to go and look into that and get more details about it, right? So the next one is circuit breaking. Let's say there is a request coming to your service and your service is not responding. At one point of time, you know, if it is going to take too long, we have to disconnect that. So that is why circuit breakers come into the picture, and we can configure in such a way. Let's say, hey, this API is taking more than 2 seconds, or this API is taking more than 500 milliseconds. We can set up the configuration and we can break that API and we can go into the next API. That's why the circuit breaking principles are applied in the API gateway level, right? So the last item I have is the developer portal. Developer portal is very important when we look for an API gateways, right? So with the help of a developer portal, we can have all the documentations. We can configure the signatures or the keys where the customers can use it, right? So when we want to have a right API gateway, you know, you have to look for all this information when you are configured within your system, right? So let's talk about API management tools. The first one I have is Apigee, which is from Google, and it is one of the most popular API management tool, right? I have personally worked on that, and it has a lot of flexibility and features for high volume systems. And this is also another popular tool, which we call as Nginx Plus, which is from M5, right? I have not worked on this, but it is popular in the cloud environment, right? And we have TYK, which is an open source, and you can freely download that and install and try, right? And if you're using AWS, and there is a ready-made tool, which is from AWS, which is Amazon API Management. You have all the features, or most of the features are covered in the Amazon API Management tool, right? Thank you very much. That's it I have. Bye.